On the Sacramento River in the town of Walnut Grove, workers on a construction barge, including divers, are putting together a structure that looks kind of like a lighting grid that would hang over a rock concert. It does have lights attached.
High density LED lighting, basically, that's going to reflect into the bubbles.
And yes, it's going to blow bubbles and make noises. All of this underwater, creating a sensory environment that repels fish. It's called a bioacoustic fish fence. The Department of Water Resources provided us with video of a test of the system inside a warehouse. If you're sensitive to flashing lights, you might want to close your eyes for just a few seconds.
We're hoping the project is going to be done end of October and is going to be operational by November 15.
Shahid Anwar, a senior engineer for the Department of Water Resources, is the project manager in Walnut Grove. He says the bioacoustic fish fences have proven effective in other places.
So it's going to basically help us to make sure the salmon is not going to get into the Georgiana Slough.
Endangered Chinook salmon on their way to the ocean sometimes take a wrong turn. Here, where the Sacramento River meets Georgiana Slough, this is where the bioacoustic barrier is being installed.
Studies have shown the chance of survival for the salmon drops dramatically if they end up here in Georgiana Slough, because in this body of water, they're exposed to many dangers, especially predator fish that like to feed on salmon.
Georgiana Slough leads to the interior delta, where the danger increases. An earlier version of the bioacoustic barrier was tested here in Walnut Grove in 2011 and 2012. Anwar says it reduced the number of fish going wayward into the slough by 67% in 2011 and 50% in 2012.
Even if passed through, it's not going to harm them.
Compared to a physical barrier, the bioacoustic method doesn't impede water flows or boat traffic.
We hired some consultant. They did a lot of navigational analysis and make sure it's not going to impact any kind of navigation. Yes.
The project cost is in the millions of dollars, and it's paid for by the California Water Project, which balances the water needs of people and nature.
So this is basically saving the juvenile Chinook salmon. Yes.
In Walnut Grove, covering local news that matters, Dennis Shanahan, Fox 40 News.